On the season 3 premiere of 5 Things, we're gonna take a look at live streaming and how the LiveU Solo holds up against the Teradek VidiU Pro. Stay tuned. Hello and welcome to the season 3 premiere of 5 Things, a web series dedicated to answering the 5 burning tech questions that you have about technologies and workflows in the media creation space, plus tech stuff I dig and how it's used. I'm still your host, Michael Kamis, and we're back for another season of delving into the who, what, and why of technology, what's BS and what's not, plus reviews, busting post myths, but most importantly, getting you knowledgeable on the logic behind the creativity. In this episode, we're going to dive deep into live streaming. Sure, your phone can do it, but if you want a professional live stream to YouTube or Facebook or just about anywhere else, then this episode is for you. My friends over at LiveU asked me to do a deep dive on their Solo streaming device. I suggested, why not a shootout between the Teradek VidiU Pro, which is another similar device. So, is that cool with you, LiveU?
We would love for you to review the LiveU bonded encoder and tell us what you think. Be absolutely honest, tell us what works, what doesn't, anything that you find.
Alrighty then.
So, we're going to start this season off with a review of the LiveU Solo and how it squares off against the Teradek VidiU Pro. Let's get started. Both units have a ton of similarities, so let's get those out of the way first so we can focus on the ooey gooey differences. At the core of both units is the ability to take an SD or HD video source, usually HDMI, encode the signal, and stream it out to the web to sites like YouTube or Facebook. This can be done via a traditional Ethernet connection. You can go mobile with Wi-Fi, or even stream via a USB cellular 3G or 4G connection. Both the LiveU Solo and Teradek VidiU Pro have the ability to bond across a number of onboard connections, which gives you the ability to have an added level of not only redundancy, but also throughput, to ensure your signal is getting out smoothly and at the highest bandwidth possible. Both units, however, charge extra for this feature, which I'll get into later. Both models are small in size and both weigh under a pound, although the VidiU Pro is less than half a pound, and they easily mount on your camera or attach to your Batman utility belt.
Where does he get those wonderful toys?
The units can run off of AC and also have built-in batteries, so you can stream for several hours before having to recharge. Both models also have web page backends to help control the units, to varying degrees. The Solo and VidiU Pro both do their jobs very well, but the devil is certainly in the details, and that's what we're going to tackle next. The LiveU and Teradek units both allow setup via a web browser on your computer or mobile device, LiveU via the LiveU portal, and Teradek via the web server on the unit. LiveU is pretty straightforward. Create an account at solo.liveu.tv, boot up your LiveU Solo unit, although this may take a while, and connect your Solo to the internet. Then, enter in your Solo serial number into the portal, and you're off and running. You now can do your entire streaming configuration of the Solo signal on the web page for your unit. Now, this is a blessing and a curse, which I'll get into a bit later on. Teradek setup is very similar. Boot up the unit, which doesn't take as long as LiveU, and get your unit on the local network. It doesn't even have to have access to the internet at this point. It just needs an IP address so your local computers or Wi-Fi enabled cellular devices can see it. Unlike the Solo, the VidiU Pro has a web server built in, which makes configuration a bit easier. Why is that, Michael? Having the local web server built in means I don't have to have internet connectivity on my laptop or workstation if I'm out in the field and I want to configure the unit. Yeah, I know you can use cellular devices like your phone to configure the unit, but what if cellular service on location is lacking for your phone's carrier? Now what? It's a slight issue, but I think having a web server built into the unit, as Teradek does, makes for an easier way of local configuration. Speaking of cellular connections, at this point, if you're planning on going out into the great wide open and streaming via 4G connections, make sure you've purchased your cellular modems and chosen the right data plan. One that won't throttle your bandwidth or cut you off at the knees during an event.
Hey, if If anybody needs to make a call, I've got a phone.
Now it's time for the speeds and feeds and goes ins, goes outs part of our review. For that, I think LiveU has the upper hand. With two USB ports, the Solo offers an extra layer of USB connectivity. Normally, this would be used for 4G cellular modems, which means you can bond across 4G connections and across multiple carriers for a smoother streaming experience. Plus, while the Solo itself is HDMI, LiveU does offer an SDI model for a bit of a bump in price. So those of you with pro cameras don't need to have another converter with you in your bag of tricks. What Teradek VidiU Pro lacks in a second USB connection, it kind of makes up for an onboard recording. The Teradek unit can handle an SD or SDHC card, so you can record a local copy of your incoming signal. This comes in handy if you plan to do a cutdown later. There is also a major difference in the way audio is handled. The VidiU Pro has an 1/8-inch audio input. Maybe you're pumping in a mic or music from another source. There's also an 1/8-inch jack for headphones as well. The Solo only has one 1/8-inch jack, and right now it's inactive, designed for future expansion. This is where comparisons get tricky, because this is where we begin to see the sweet spots for each unit. LiveU has many more built-in CDN presets. CDNs, or content delivery networks, are the endpoints you would broadcast to in order to make your content viewable by everyone in the world, like YouTube or Facebook. The Solo has twice the amount of optimized and tweaked presets out of the box than the VidiU Pro. However, both units do allow for generic RTMP, or real-time messaging protocol, which is a rather generic way of streaming online, so you can manually create presets for just about any online outlet with minimal headache. Both devices have configuration panels on the front of the unit via joysticks, but far and away, the Teradek unit has more editable info available via the front panel than the Solo does. I really like the small color preview window on the LiveU Solo, however. The preview window on the Solo gives me a bit more confidence that I'm sending out the right signal. And if it's right from the camera, I can verify that there are none of those pesky overlays on the image. The flip side is that I can't test the Solo's streaming functionality without a valid input signal. This makes the Solo a bit difficult to test if the other parts of your streaming rig, like the camera or the switcher, are not already set up. I'd love a built-in bars and tone generator with the streaming specs overlaid over the signal for this very purpose. Now, when streaming, battery life is of paramount concern. The Solo boasts a 2-hour battery, while the Teradek boasts 3 hours. I tested this out by setting both units to their max bitrate and resolution and streamed over Wi-Fi to the same CDN until their batteries died. My testing showed that the VidiU Pro was nowhere close to the proclaimed 3 hours of battery life, failing at 108 minutes, not even making it to 2 hours. To be fair, the VidiU Pro results may be slightly skewed as the unit inexplicably stopped streaming 4 times during the test for no apparent reason, which I then had to restart the stream. By comparison, the LiveU had more than 50% of its battery remaining when the VidiU Pro died, and continued streaming for another 100 minutes after, with no dropouts. The LiveU Solo and Teradek VidiU Pro both stream in an H.264 format and deliver excellent visual quality at their respective data rates. I did find I had more flexibility with the LiveU, as I can override the unit's preset and manually specify the data rate. The VidiU Pro forced me into one of several presets. The Solo also gives me a max data rate of 5.5 megabits for video, whereas the VidiU Pro tops out at 5 megabits. Quite honestly, I don't see most folks noticing this visually unless they're really pushing the limits of the 1080p 60. Another point on 1080p 60. This is very important for sports, both live and e-gaming based, and other content where you want the largest frame size and frame rate possible. The VidiU Pro tops out at 1080p 30 and only reaches 60 frames at 720p. If your endpoint is demanding 1080p 60, then LiveU is going to be your first choice. The Solo also encodes in an H.264 high profile, while the VidiU Pro simply supports main profile. This means more efficient compression that should manifest in better visual quality at lower data rates. It's also the profile that's traditionally used for larger screen HD monitors, while main profile is generally reserved for smaller screens and less powerful devices like tablets and smartphones. LiveU takes a staggered approach to streaming. The data rate starts low and climbs to the intended or available data rate, usually within 60 seconds or so. This can be problematic for those who are running and gunning and need to go live instantaneously.
Right. What it does is it creates a dimensional gateway that allows it to jump instantaneously from one point of the universe to another light years away.
Wow.
Well, it's difficult to, it's all math.
I see it as a safeguard to have a stream start smoothly while buffering. You can certainly work around this by starting a stream, but not going live on your CDN until you hit your desired data rate. VidiU Pro, by comparison, starts at the desired bitrate as soon as you start streaming. LiveU also has a cool tech called LRT, or LiveU Reliable Transport, a tech that they actually hold the patent on. This includes forward error correcting, packet ordering, which is mandatory when bonding across multiple signals, and adaptive bitrate encoding. It's the adaptive part I like, because the audio is always made to maintain a higher priority of quality to video. So even if the bandwidth drops, the audio quality will remain good. Keep in mind, utilizing LRT on the Solo is an extra $45 a month charge. But then again, ShareLink from Teradek, which also provides bonding across connection methods, is also an upcharge per month, depending on your bandwidth needs. Now, in terms of streaming reliability during my testing, the VidiU Pro stopped streaming for unknown reasons a handful of times, four in fact, during a nearly 2-hour stream test, while the Solo never stopped streaming until I told the unit to do so. I was able to replicate this behavior during other shorter tests as well. I wish when the VidiU Pro ran into a streaming issue, it would try and correct itself more. Whenever the stream was interrupted, I had to manually restart the stream on the Teradek unit. It's obvious, both of these systems will serve you well. However, with the extra USB port for a cellular modem, the granular control over streaming bit rates and H.264 high profile settings, the larger choice of built-in CDNs, the awesome LRT tech, fantastic battery life, and not one interrupted stream during my testing, the Solo is the best choice when streaming is your number one concern. It's simply meant for mission-critical streaming in broadcast situations. If I had to choose one portable unit to encode and stay on the air, it would be the Solo. Now, the Teradek VidiU Pro unit is part of a larger, much broader Teradek ecosystem, which includes many of their other hardware apps and their software solution for bonding, ShareLink. More web portal control, the ability to record onboard the unit and make changes from the device make the VidiU Pro a great Swiss Army knife. But the shortened battery life and interruptions during streaming make the VidiU Pro seem to be a jack of all trades, but a master of none. Have more questions about the LiveU Solo versus the VidiU Pro other than just these five? Ask me in the comments section. Also, please subscribe and share this tech goodness with the rest of your techie friends. You can also stalk me online if you'd like to. I'm pretty easy to find. My special thanks to LiveU for their financial support and sponsorship of this episode. And until the next episode, learn more, do more. Thanks for watching.